Welcome. Today is Thursday, January 26th, and this is the International Space Station update from Mission Control at the Johnson Space Center in Houston. Today on board the International Space Station, that Expedition 30 crew has been busy this morning. They've already had their breakfast and their lunch. Don Pettit has been working on the ISAC, which is the International Space Station Agricultural Camera. That camera takes photos of vegetated areas of the Northern Great Plains. The camera was built by students at the University of North Dakota and is actually run by those students. In addition, Pettit has also been working on a number of other things in the lab. He made sure that that agricultural camera was open. Andre Coupers has been working with the viable payload. That payload is a study that involves the evaluation of microbial biofilms. It actually studies the space materials. It looks at the metal and textile space materials, and he's been working on that this morning. He's also been working on the compound-specific analyzer. That's an analyzer that does some studies on oxygen in the International Space Station. Coupers also has been spending some time working on the Cabot Laboratory. He's been working on the clean bench functional checkout. The clean bench is part of the JAXA, or Japanese Aerospace Exploration Agency, experiments. It's a facility located in that laboratory, and it is located in the Cyboy, which is also known as the Living Cell Experiment Rack. That clean bench has two compartments, a disinfection chamber and an operation chamber. And air is circulated inside to keep it clean. Crew members operate the experiment materials from outside using gloves to prevent contamination of the ambient air. And that also has a very extreme microscope so that they can study the articles in that experiment. Coupers also has been doing some swapping this morning. He's been swapping telemetry cables from the KU antenna group number 2 to number 1. And this will provide better television for us here at the Johnson Space Center as we capture images from the International Space Station. Also in other activities, Commander Burbank and Don Pettit have been working with nutrition activities throughout the day. They've been working on the Spheres Port Assembly, and they've also been working in the Melfi.
And
the International Space Station Progress 46 cargo craft is also on its way to the International Space Station today. It launched late yesterday at 5:06 p.m. Central Time from the Baikonur Cosmodrome in Kazakhstan. After reaching orbit and deploying its solar arrays and navigational antennas, the Progress will conduct two automated rendezvous burns. This will fine-tune its path to the International Space Station. Another such burn is on tap for later this afternoon, with docking to the Pier's docking compartment scheduled for tomorrow at 6 p.m. Central Time. That craft is loaded with nearly 3 tons of water, air, propellant, and equipment for the International Space Station. In other space station news, the same piece of space debris that has had NASA considering safe haven for the crew and the Soyuz vehicles earlier this week is still being tracked by our ballistics team. Overnight, the TOPOs, or the Trajectory Operations Officers, were informed that another possible conjunction with that same piece of Chinese Fengyang satellite debris, with two possible close encounters for the station coming in the wee hours Sunday, that is being monitored by the crew and by the team here at the NASA's Johnson Space Center. As of this morning, that is considered a medium concern for the International Space Station crew. But again, mission controllers are considering some possible tweaks to the station's orbit after the docking of the Progress 46 Friday night. Today at NASA is the Day of Remembrance, as we honor the crews of Apollo 1, Challenger, and Columbia. We'll be honoring the men and women who lost their lives during the space agency's space exploration program. We celebrate their lives and their bravery and the advancement in human spaceflight. Today, here at the Johnson Space Center at 2 p.m. Central Time, we will pause to remember those crews, the crews of Apollo 1, Challenger, and Columbia. These astronauts and their families will always be a part of NASA.